That's right. Looking forward to it. It's exciting.
I know.
Exciting to me. It's fresh. Hey, welcome back to Honest Rapper Reactions. I'm Metal Dad.
And I'm Banger Mom.
In 6 weeks, over 100 videos. So you do the math. We've heard a lot of rap, a lot of Kendrick, a lot of Kanye. Mm-hmm. Head over to our playlist, check those out. We have tons of videos. Don't forget to smash the like button. And don't forget that April 1st,
we'll be launching our Patreon. So as we go along, we're going to tease you with what the kind of rewards we'll be offering you. Today, we're continuing Kendrick's album, Kid M.A.A.D City. Oh. So we do some albums because, you know, they're really good albums. So you can't really just not do the whole album. And then we do some randoms for those albums that, you know, kind of, we don't really want to listen to the whole album.
So stay tuned for some randoms that you'll be seeing in the next couple of days. Now we're on three of them if you're new. We're on Rodeo Travis Scott that we're almost coming to an end with. Mm-hmm. We're doing Kanye's College Dropout and
Kendrick's Good Kid M.A.A.D City.
So I guess it's time to listen to The Art of Peer Pressure.
The Art of Peer Pressure.
What do you get out of what this might be about?
Peer pressure.
Okay.
And about him realizing that boy was stupid what he did, what he thought he had to do in Compton. He's gonna go do something bad.
Yeah. I got a pistol. But he's like, I'm just with my homies.
It's the peer pressure. It's just like his perspective on what he's been through.
Everybody sit your bitch ass down and listen to this true motherfucking story told by Kendrick Lamar Rosecrans, you bitch.
Start. I love that crackling of the record.
Never been much of a vinyl guy, but
I guess you wouldn't have, you know.
No, I was
when
born.
You were born, like your dad had vinyls, then cassettes came in.
So. I had the Michael Jackson Thriller album as a vinyl. Remember that? But I didn't have a record player.
I had it
player.
As a tape. It was the first album I ever got.
Cool. What was the first album you guys got? Let us know, right? Let us know what you guys were listening to when you were little. 90s, maybe some of you are NSYNC fans. Yeah. That's right. And if you're born in the 2000s right now and watching, I have no clue what you grew up listening to. Like Britney Spears or like what?
What? Like Justin Bieber?
Oh, maybe Kendrick.
Or yeah, Kendrick. Like what we're listening to right now, baby. Yeah.
With the Gonzalez Park odor. We on the mission for bad bitches in trouble. I hope the universe love you today. Cause the energy we bring is sure to carry away a flock of positive activists and fill their body with hate if it's necessary. Bump a cheesy first album looking distracted. Speaking language only we know you think it's an accent. The windows roll down, all I see is a hand pass it. Hotboxing like George Foreman, grilling the masses of the working world. We pulled up on a bunch of working girls and asked them what they're working with. Look at me, I got the blunt in my mouth. Usually I'm drug free, but shit, I'm with the homies.
Yeah, nigga, we out for peeling Remy Red. Come through and bust your head, nigga.
Me and the homies.
Sag all the way to the liquor store where my niggas pour full and get twisted some more.
Me and the homies.
I ride for my motherfucking niggas. Hop out, do my stuff, then hop back in.
Me and the homies.
Matter of fact, I hop out that motherfucking.
Nah, I'm getting this, not chill, but I'm getting this kind of like something that I kind of experienced in high school. you know, the peer pressure.
Oh, yeah, to do certain things.
He doesn't want to be there. He doesn't even want to be with them, and he has to be.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of was in situations like that where I was like, what am I doing here?
I hope the universe love you today because the energy we bring ensure that to carry away.
Be the leader, you know, but we end up a lot of times being the followers.
Well, obviously, you know? Because you want people to like you and you just want to fit in. So you're going to do shitty shit.
Last cut, the song had changed.
Oh, something totally. Happened. It was I thought I was listening to a different song.
Yeah, that was impactful. Anyway, I really like that.
Broken, I hear my stomach screaming. Hungry for anything unhealthy, and if nutrition can help me, I'll tell you to suck my dick, then I'll continue eating. We speeding on the 405 passing Westchester. You know the light skinned girls and all the little dresses, good lord. They knew we weren't for round there, cause every time we down there, we pulling out the Boost Mobile SIM cards. Bougie bitches with no extensions, hood niggas with bad intentions, the perfect combination. Before we sparked the conversation, we seen three niggas in colors we didn't like, then start interrogating. I never was a gangbanger, I mean I never was stranger to the funk neither. I really doubt it. Rush a nigga quick and then we laugh about it. That's ironic, cause I never been violent until I'm with the homies.
Just riding, just riding.
Me and the homies.
Bullshit, acting a fool.
Me and the homies.
Tripping.
Me and the homies.
Just riding, just riding, just riding.
Bragging about the episode we just had. A shot of Hennessy didn't make me feel that bad. I'm usually a true firm believer of bad karma. Consequences from evil will make you pass, haunt ya. We trying to conquer the city with disobedience. Quick to turn it up even if we ain't got the CD in. But Jeezy still playing and our attitude is still, nigga, what is you saying? Pull in front of the house that we've been camping out for like 2 months. The sun is going down as we take whatever we want.
Hey, hey, nigga, jackpot, nigga, find the safe.
Hey, nigga, I see somebody in this room.
Wait, what?
Somebody in this room.
I hit the back window in search of any Nintendo DVDs, plasma screen TVs in the trunk. We made a right, they made a left, they made a right, they made a left. We was just circling life, my mama called.
Hello? What you doing?
Kicking it, I should have told her I'm probably about to catch my first offense with the homies. But they made a right, they made a left, they made a right, then another right. One lucky night with the homies.
Hey, how you faded, love?
Yeah, we finally got that nigga faded.
Ooh!
Pretty on now.
I think he hit the wrong blunt, though.
Ooh, which one are you talking about? Which one you talking about?
I hope he hit the one with the shenanigans, eh? I'm afraid he hit that.
Nah, that nigga straight, he ain't hit that one.
Not the shenanigans? Yeah, that nigga the shenanigans.
Nigga, I think we should push back to the city, for real, though.
Nigga, for what?
What's that nigga? What's that Jeezy song say, nigga? Nigga, last time I checked, I was a man on these streets. Man, yeah, that shit right there. I'm trying to be the nigga in the street. There you go. Man, you know how the shit go. All right, here's the plan, love. We're gonna use the kickback as an alibi. Wait till the song go down, roll out, plead the mission, drop K Dot off at his mama van, head the park, cause I know he trying to fuck on Shireen tonight. Yeah, yeah, that's not gonna do it. Then we all gonna meet back at the block at about 10:30.
That's straight, bro. We should just meet up around 12. I'm trying to fuck on something too.
Nigga, sit your dumb ass back down, nigga. You ain't finna do shit tonight. Matter of fact, nigga, get in the motherfucking car. We finna get active.
What a great song.
Wow.
I really, really enjoyed that. How do you guys like it? What is your chill factor for this song?
That perspective there, eh? It's crazy.
I don't really want to be there, but when I'm there, I'm with my homies. I'm gonna give it a 4.
Yeah, I was thinking of 4 too. Just for the whole peer pressure message, the lyrics in this. I really like that you're appreciating the lyrics now. You know, that you're really...
I'm trying to take more time to it.
I love the talk parts of a song that just give us a glimpse. We didn't think we'd be like, okay, we got to dig deep into albums now, you know? And and obviously, especially with this album, it all falls into each other.
I think we all are on the same wavelength. This one, lots of people must love it. So I think we're going to call that quits for today. Dad out.
Peace out.